There are realms of the Holy Ghost that God wants to take the church into. This has been happening a lot in the meetings lately. One night, I sang my whole message, sang the altar call. I think I sang for about an hour and a half. I'm telling you, people left that night totally bombed on the Holy Ghost. I mean, I'm talking about drunk. Drunk. And sometimes we can get into so much tradition. I know some people, they're waiting for the main part of the service. I don't know why you're waiting. It's here. Oh, hallelujah. Someone said, I never heard somebody sing their message. Someone said, I never heard somebody sing the altar call. I'll tell you one thing I haven't done is sing the offering. I might still do that one of these days. But let's be open to the Holy Ghost. See, we need to learn by precept and example. Because sometimes we don't really have precept and example. We just have the do's and don'ts. But I tell you, we're in the presence of the Holy Ghost. It's whatever He wants to do. Can you say amen? I said it's whatever He wants to do. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. Rejoice. 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 Rejoice, lift your voice to the King. Come on now, rejoice,
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 rejoice.
Lift your voice to the King. I tell you, I'm so excited about what the Lord's doing. I can hardly contain myself. I'm so drunk, I can't even. I got it. It was where I thought it was. Hallelujah. I want you to take your Bibles and open, please, to 1 Kings chapter 17. We're going to receive tonight's offering. Before we do, let's read what the Word says. As you know, this is the tradition in our meetings that we have fallen into. But remember, I said tradition's good as long as there's life. If the tradition brings death, then throw it out. Amen. Praise God. 1 Kings 17 in verse 1. Now I know this might be hard for some of you, but if you could just try to turn the volume down just a tad. Just for the benefit of the straight-faced around you. Just turn the volume down. You can laugh silently now. 1 Kings 17 verse 1. Elijah the Tishbite. If I had a name Tishbite, I'd change it. Of the temporary resident, maybe that's why he was just temporary, of Gilead, said to Ahab, as the Lord, the God of Israel, lives before whom I stand, there shall not be dew or rain these years, but according to my word. And the word of the Lord came to him, saying, go from here, turn east, and hide yourself Brother Brook Cherith, east of Jordan. You shall drink of the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed you there. So he did according to the word of the Lord, and went and dwelt by the brook Cherith, east of Jordan. And the ravens brought him bread and flesh in the morning, and bread and flesh in the evening, and he drank of the brook. After a while, the brook dried up because there was no rain in the land, and then the word of the Lord came to him, and God gave him another direction to go. Now, it's very important that you notice here that by the mouth of the prophet of God, by the mouth of the prophet of God, a famine came in the land. But God had a way made, because he is the way maker. He had a way made for the prophet to have supernatural provision in the midst of the dearth. Supernatural provision. He sent him to the brook Cherith, and the ravens were to come and to feed him in the morning and in the evening. Now, you know as well as I do that ravens do not feed anybody except themselves. Ravens are selfish birds, and they really just take care of themselves. But you know, God will even cause selfish people to be loosed to where they'll start to bless you and they won't even know why they're doing it. Now, the ravens were coming to the brook. Don't kid yourself, they weren't coming there just for the prophet. They were coming there to have a drink of water. But God said, on your way to the brook, stop by McDonald's, pick up a Big Mac, and take it to the prophet of God. Well, that's true. That's what it says. Bread and flesh in the morning, bread and flesh in the evening. Sounds like a hamburger to me. I don't know about you, but sounds like a hamburger. Now, I can understand where the ravens got the meat from. I don't have a problem trying to work out where the ravens picked the meat up from. It obviously was a camel running through the desert about 40 miles an hour, knocked over a rabbit, and the ravens picked some meat up and took it to the prophet of God. But have you ever thought for one moment, where did the ravens get the bread from? Somebody was baking the bread. But after a while, the brook dried up and the ravens didn't come anymore, but God had another plan for the prophet. He said to him, arise and go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a multimillionaireess there to provide for you. How many believe that? Say amen. Well, should read your Bible, because that's not what it said. He said, I have provided a widow. A widow. I've commanded a widow. You can imagine the prophet saying, well, thank you, God. That's wonderful. That, I mean, just phenomenal. Of all people in the city, you got to choose a widow. But he, you know, he arose, went to Zarephath. When he came to the gates of the city, behold, a widow was there gathering sticks, and he called to her, bring me a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to get it, he called to her and said, bring me a morsel of bread in your hand. Now, I want you to stop and think for a moment. How many think that a request for a drink of water is a valid request. Raise your hand. But he didn't stop with the drink of water. He went a step further. He placed a demand on this woman that was a little bit, she would have to go out of her way. The water, you know, anybody can get a drink of water, but now he's asking for food. She says to him, as the Lord your God lives, I have not a loaf baked, but only a handful of meal. Everybody say, handful of meal. In a jar and a little oil. Everybody say, little oil. Little oil. Say, handful. Little oil. Little oil. Turn the person next to you. Say, handful. And little oil. Little oil. Turn to the person the other side of you. Say, handful. And little oil. This woman didn't have much. She said, yeah, I'm gathering two sticks that I may go in and bake it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die. What a future they had. This was the Last Supper. You can imagine the little boy, you know how excited children are. What are we going to do tonight, not mommy? Oh, we're going to eat our final meal and then we're going to die. Oh, can't we die before we eat? Not much to look forward to. And if the newspapers got a hold of the story, because he says, fear not, go and do as you have said, but make me a little cake of it first. If the newspapers got a hold of it, it would have read in the headlines, preacher robs woman of final social security check. People would have said, that's a typical preacher, there he is. The woman, at any time, she could have said, look, I don't care, Tish, bite, whatever bite you are, you're not eating my food. I'll give you water, but I'm not giving you any food. But God wasn't wanting to take the little that the woman had away from her to rob her of the little that she had. God wanted to take what the woman would give and wanted to multiply it, not only to feed her, but also her household and also the prophet of God. And he wanted to bring her into a place of provision. And many times, in order to come into a place of provision, it takes a step of obedience where you are willing to do your part and you're willing to give your part. And when you're willing to give your part, then God comes along and he multiplies it and he gives it back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. And what you started out with, the little that you started out with, is so multiplied that when you thought you had not even enough for your own family, suddenly you're feeding the neighborhood and suddenly you're feeding everybody else round about you. And you say, is it possible that God could take the little that I had and feed my whole neighborhood? Yes, I'll tell you what, a little becomes much when you put it in the master's hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, for thus says the Lord God of Israel, the jar of meal shall not fail till the day that the Lord sends rain on the earth. She did as Elijah said. 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 And she and he and her household ate for many days. Hallelujah. And the jar of meal was not spent, nor did the bottle of oil fail, according to the word which the Lord spoke through Elijah. And you read on afterwards, you find out her son died and he raised him up from the dead. The woman not only came into a miracle of provision, but also came into a miracle where her son was brought back to life. I'll tell you, dear friends, let me just say this tonight before we receive this offering. It's one little step of obedience, sometimes in the very smallest things. I'm telling you, yes, it's Pastor Bob Rogers, Evangel, Louisville, Kentucky. Little did you know, when you and your father, W.L. Rogers, came to South Africa and your dad looked over at me and said, come preach in my church. Little did you know that that was the open door for me to come to this wonderful country and to do what God said do. Just one little step of obedience. When his father looked at me and said, I want you to come and preach in my church, that's the open door that I'd been praying for. Lord, open the door. Open the door. You open the door. And his father said, I want you to come. And then he fixed me up a whole lot of meetings and the rest is history. Thank you. One step of obedience and see the multitude that are being fed. Hallelujah. I'll tell you, God's got an accounting system. You might think it's gone unrecognized. You think God doesn't notice, but he's got it all down. He hasn't missed one little figure. Can you say amen? Amen. Hallelujah. One step of obedience. Say this after me. One step of obedience will unlock the floodgates of heaven. One step of obedience will cause the river of God's blessing to flow in my life. How many thank God that 1995 is the year of the river of the blessing of God in your life? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to bow your heads right now. You just ask God what he have you do. Remember, one step of obedience, that's all he requires of you. Remember, little becomes much when you put it in the master's hand. As God can provide for the widow woman, he can provide for you. I don't care what your circumstances are tonight. I don't care what you're facing. I don't care how it looks like you've reached the bottom of life's barrel. I'll tell you right now, he can cause it that it'll never fail and that you will walk in miracle, abundance, supernatural supply. If you'll believe God and step out and walk on the water, walk on the water of the supernatural. Don't sit in the boat of doubt and unbelief, but walk on the water of the supernatural and see the glory of God. Father, we just thank you even tonight as your people give. We thank you that even as you provided for this widow woman, Lord, you brought her into supernatural abundant supply. You know the needs of your people here tonight. And Father, all it takes is one step of obedience. As they obey you, cause that river to begin to be made manifest in their life. Many times, Lord, just the smallest thing that we do unlocks the greatest blessing. I pray tonight that you bless the gift and the giver. Lord, even those that don't have seed to sow, I pray that before the week's out, that you'd grant to them seed that they can sow, that they can be a part of that which you're doing in the earth today through this ministry. In Jesus' name we pray, and everyone said. I want you to take your Bibles tonight, please, and open to the book of Acts. I began to speak last night on the realms of God, and I felt led of the Lord to continue along the line tonight. There's so much the Holy Ghost wants to do, but unfortunately we've put him in a box. But I believe the box has been broken. Can you say amen? Now, last night we looked at and we saw that Paul had an experience with God where he was caught up into the third heaven, caught up into paradise. Or you could say this, he was caught up into the realms of God. Now let me just interject my message by just saying this. I know some of you think, well, how can he get up and speak after what's just happened? You know, to me, it's all the same. I mean, I have to get used to it. I've over 5.5 years now of this, so I just go on ahead with business as usual. Whatever else happens is fine by me. But if you can listen, it'll be all right. And then we looked over in the book of Revelation and we saw that John on the Isle of Patmos, the Amplified Bible says, I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. I was wrapped. I was wrapped in his presence. And there's realms of the glory that we've just touched on. There's realms of the supernatural that we've just touched on. Those that call themselves charismatic and those who call themselves Pentecostal are operating on such a low level of the supernatural. There's the low levels, but there's also the higher realms of God that God wants to take the church to in this day and in this hour. Can you say amen? Amen. And it all has to do with one thing, and that one thing is yielding to the Holy Ghost. Not listening to what your mind would tell you. I'll be honest with you, there are many times when I'm standing in a place of ministry and my mind is telling me 101 different things, but I always tell my head to shut up and I follow what I feel in my heart. Can you say amen? And your head will tell you, you're going to miss it. You're going to blow it. God's not concerned about people who miss it. God's concerned about people who miss it and won't repent when they missed it. I want you to now read with me Acts chapter 10. This passage of scripture has meant so much to me the last 6 months of the revival meetings. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band. A devout man and one that feared God, and with all his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. And he saw in a vision, evidently about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. Now I want you to see here that there are, or there is, that which is known as visitation of angels. The Bible is so clear when it says, be careful when you entertain strangers, for some have entertained angels unawares. And he said, yeah, the angel said, and when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, what is it, Lord? And he said unto him, thy prayers and thine alms are come up for a memorial before God. And now send men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter. He lodgeth with one Simon a tanner, whose house is by the seaside. And he shall tell thee what thou oughtest to do. And when the angel which spake unto Cornelius was departed, he called two of his household servants and a devout soldier of them that waited on him continually. And when he had declared all these things unto them, he sent them to Joppa. Now I want you to see on the other side what was taking place. On the morrow, as they went on their journey and drew nigh unto the city, Peter went up. Peter went up. Peter went up. Peter went up on the housetop to pray about the sixth hour, and he became very hungry and would have eaten, but while they made ready, he fell into a trance. And he saw a heaven opened and a certain vessel descending unto him, as it had been a great sheet knit at the four corners and let down to the earth, wherein were all manner of four-footed beasts of the earth and wild beasts and creeping things and fowls of the air. And there came a voice to him, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat." But Peter said, "Not so, Lord, for I have never eaten anything that is common or unclean." And the voice spake again unto him again the second time, "What God hath cleansed, that call not thou common." This was done thrice, and the vessel was received up again into heaven. Now while Peter doubted in himself what this vision which he had seen should mean, behold, the men which were sent from Cornelius had made inquiry for Simon's house and stood before the gate and called and asked whether Simon, which was surnamed Peter, was lodged there. While Peter thought on the vision, the Spirit said unto him, "Behold, three men seek thee. Arise, therefore, get thee down, and go with them, doubting nothing, for I have sent them." Then Peter went down to the men which were sent unto him from Cornelius, and said, "Behold, I am he whom ye seek. What is the cause wherefore ye are come?" And they said, "Cornelius, the centurion, a just man, one that feareth God, and of good report among all the nation of the Jews, was warned from God by a holy angel to send for thee into his house and to hear words of thee. Then called he them in and lodged them. And on the morrow Peter went away with them, and certain brethren from Joppa accompanied him. And the morrow after they entered into Caesarea, and Cornelius waited for them, and had called together his kinsmen and near friends. And as Peter was coming in, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him. But Peter took him up, saying, "Stand up. I myself also am a man." And as he talked with him, he went in and found many that were come together. And he said unto them, "Ye know how that it is an unlawful thing for a man that is a Jew to keep company or come unto one of another nation. But God hath showed me that I should not call any man common or unclean. Therefore came I unto you without gainsaying. As soon as I was sent for, I asked therefore for what intent ye have sent for me. Now listen, and Cornelius said, 4 days ago I was fasting until this hour. At the ninth hour I prayed in my house, and behold, a man stood before me in bright clothing and said, Cornelius, thy prayer is heard, and thine alms are had in remembrance in the sight of God. Send therefore to Joppa and call hither Simon, whose surname is Peter. He's lodged in the house of one Simon a tanner by the seaside, who when he cometh shall speak unto thee. Immediately therefore I sent to thee, and thou hast well done that thou art come. Now therefore are we all here present before God to hear all these things that are commanded thee of God? Then Peter opened his mouth and said, of a truth I perceive that God is no respecter of persons, but in every nation he that feareth him and worketh righteousness is accepted with him. The word which God sent unto the children of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all. That word I say ye know, which was published throughout all Judea and began from Galilee after the baptism which John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with them. And we are witnesses of all things which he did, both in the land of the Jews and in Jerusalem, whom they slew and hanged on a tree. Him God raised up on the third day and showed him openly, not to all the people, but unto witnesses chosen before of God, even to us who did eat and drink with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach unto the people and to testify that it is he which was ordained of God to be the judge of the quick and the dead. To him give all the prophets witness that through his name whosoever believeth in him shall receive remission of sins. While Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word. May the Lord bless the reading of his word to our hearts. Thank you. can really say at this point, it is a joy unspeakable and full of glory, and the heart has never yet been told. Don't think that this is strange tonight. Heaven is coming down in this place. 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 Heaven is coming down. Heaven is coming down. It's raining. It's rain. It's the 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 rain! 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 It's raining! It's raining! Get your eyes on Jesus. 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 If this makes you nervous, I don't know what you're going to do when you get to heaven. I hear the sound of heaven here tonight. I hear the sound of heaven here tonight. I hear the sound of heaven's joy bells ringing in this place. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Step up into the realm of God. Step up into the realm of God. Step out of the realm of the natural into the realm of the supernatural. Step up into the realms of God. Step out of the realm of the mind. Step over in the realm of the supernatural. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, nanamakuria stokuriala mandoya. Oh, riala baso, riala paya. Manamangiria steriala stokuriala. Oh, riala baso, riala le. Oh, riala mando.
Maria, 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 Ma
For I am the Lord, I change not. And even as I moved in days gone by, surely I move in this hour. For even as my servant Moses stood before that burning bush, and I did commission him, even so this night I'm calling many of you, say the Lord. You see my fire, you hear my voice. I'm calling you to go. Will you obey? You say, Lord, I cannot go, I cannot speak. But oh, even this night I do anoint your lips. Even this night I do take a coal from off of the altar and I place it upon your lips. Even this night I place my hand upon you. Even the lowliest among you, even the outcast among you, my hand even rest upon you, even in this time, say the Lord, and I call you forth. Will you go? Will you go? For the world, even at this time, cries out, for they walk in darkness, for they've not heard about Jesus. They've not heard about his love. They've not heard about the price that he paid on the cross, that he gave his all, and they cry out and they wander into eternal damnation. Will you go? Will you go? Will you heed the call? Will you obey? Will you listen? Will you hearken unto the voice of the Spirit of the Lord your God this night? For he calls you. Will you go? Will you go? Will you go? Will you go? Oh, the call is made out. The call is made out even now. The clarion call. Who will go? Who will go? Who will go? Who will go? I believe there are people here tonight, you're not in the ministry, but God's calling in the ministry. I want you to run down here and stand around this altar right now. The Spirit of God's calling you, quickly come. You're not in the full-time ministry, but you hear the call of the Holy Ghost tonight. You'll obey, you'll go, you'll do what he wants you to do. Come, the world cries out even now. Come, 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 you will obey. You will go, you will go, you will go. You will go, you will go, you will go, you will go, you will go. You will go, you will go, you will go, you will go. Oh, come. Oh. 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 fields. White as the snow.
White as the snow.
I see you sending me.
I see you sending me
to the fields.
To the fields. White as the snow.
So let your fire fall.
So let your fire fall. Anoint and fill me.
For it's your will, Lord.
For it's your will, Lord.
That I desire.
For it's a new day. I live my hands and say, I'll go anywhere you want me to go.
I want you to look at me right now. Some of you have been waiting for a hand to write in the sky. Some of you have been waiting for a burning bush. Some of you have been waiting for an angel. But this night, the Spirit of God has spoken to you. All it takes is a decision. Yes, Lord, I will go. Yes, Lord, I will do. I lay aside the things of the world. I lay aside that which others would say about me and to me. I give everything to you. There are people standing here right now. The Spirit of God says to me, if you will obey from this night forward, I will use you to shake nations. The glory of the Lord will cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. But He wants to flow through you to a lost and a dying world. God's breaking you free from your comfort zones right now. God's breaking you free right now. Lift your hands, the power of God's, just breaking people free right now. In the name of Jesus, I break every bondage and everything that would hold your church back in the name of Jesus, and I loose you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God, in Jesus' name. Be free. Be free. Be free. Power of God's falling all over this place right now. I said the power of God's falling all over this place right now. Jesus. Samangalus nombre vien dengalis ingalis dengalis 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 dambra viando. Zamangalus topo, domo. Let the ashes do. They'll do a better job. Sakura mangale steep step and ven ven den bristi kilistamba. Ura basta bim ve 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 stepara namba. Ura basta mangale east breve ve 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 stem bengali jiggle stombra vondo briende. Ah, radashan angali step vedea. Oh, rabasta nambri viesta mengelista. Ha, poromor di stepe ben englist. Ah, bangelist, jengelist, denglist tu. Ah, oh, reshiesta mengeliste. Colonno, mangi. Colonne, mango. Colama, brandi. Colabes, menge. Colana, branda. Colama, songo. Anama, gonje. Meneni, stambo. Menene, stembe. Manano Shomboya, Menenin Gandea, Manano Gondoye, Menenin Gendea, Mananas Tomboye, Menene Genea, Barano Stomboye, Menenis Tangaye, Menenin Brombore, Menenes Dombore, Mananan Gandale, Manano Shombora, Baradista Pile, Manano Socore, Aha, Socora Dea. Samangaliste, Sekela Bella Via Gen, Dem Bengalis, Duguru Dengle, Jungle, Dega, Ridiste, Reduce. You say what you're doing? I'm waiting for them to move the bodies. Zuguru Deba, Mengele Stapa, Pavadia Stap, Baradiesto, Mombre Via Stap, Mangaliste, Pereved Delicia, Stombon, Menge, Mangalisti, Mastumon, Sebevia. Now you start moving out into the realm of the Holy Ghost. You're going to make some people afraid. You start stepping out and moving in the Holy Ghost, you're going to make some Pentecostals afraid. You start stepping out and moving in the Holy Ghost, you're going to make some charismatics afraid. Because you see, the sum total of the move they've seen is just a bucket mouth, get up on a Sunday and go rondai, shondai, tama, bota, who shot the pecan down? And then Brother Doodad get up and go, yea, hitherto, have I not said? And then two people fall under the power and they think they had a move of God. But there's much more that God wants to do in this day and this hour, but he's just waiting for you to yield yourself and to step out. Step out. Step out. Step out of the boat of doubt and unbelief and walk on the water of the supernatural, following the unction from the Holy One. Following the unction on the inside of you, for out of your belly, some have bigger bellies than others, and so there should be a bigger river flow. Out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. It's gonna come from within. He didn't say it would come from your head. He never said it would come from your reasoning. He never said that your mind would agree. He never said that it would all make sense. He never said that everybody would understand it. He said out of your belly, not out of your head, not out of your foot, not out of your ear, not out of your eye, out of your belly, out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. Learn to follow the river bubbling up from within. Learn to follow the river that has cleansed you from all of your sin. Learn to follow the river that flows from the throne above. Learn to follow the river that is filled with his great love. Oh, Bangan Jengen Jongoye, Aroto Rabba, La Rete Ye So Praye, Rano Reyela Zorada, Ya Lebo Rezibe Raye, Oh, Now some will think you're crazy, and some will think you're mad, and some will get aggravated with you, but others will get glad. Don't worry about their faces. They don't even know how it should be done. Just follow the river that flows from the Holy One. Hallelujah! 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 It is not an act, as some people would say. No, it's just individuals following the holy way. Step by step, they follow the master's plan for everything that God would do comes directly from his hand. The realms of man and the realms of God, worlds apart they are. You can't get there by human intellect. Your reason can't go that far. But stepping out of the natural mind into the glory of God, you'll move up higher and higher and higher into his realm. Oh, how wonderful it is. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Lost in the realms of God. Gone is the care of the world. Gone is the lies of hell. Gone is the turmoil of the world below. Caught up into the realm. Caught up into the realms of the glories of God. The things of this world, oh, how small they really are when you are lifted up into the realms of Almighty God. Hallelujah. 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 I want every head bowed, every eye closed, please. For a few moments, every head bowed, every eye closed. Must obey the Holy Ghost. Must obey the Holy Ghost. While heads are bowed and eyes are closed, nobody moving around, please, just for a few minutes, if you're here. You say, Brother Rodney, I'm not born again. I don't know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Friend, I want to tell you that everything tonight, God had you in mind. The moving of the Spirit of God that you've sensed and that you feel and that you've even seen, God was reaching out to you in your chair right now. And he's saying, tonight is your night of salvation. I know that this is a camp meeting, but people come from near and from far. Some haven't given their lives to Jesus. I want you to know He loves you so very, very much. Right now He reaches out to you and He places His arms around you. You can come home to Him. Surrender everything to Him tonight. And so while heads are bowed and eyes are closed, if you're not born again, let me ask you this question. If you died right now, where would you go? If you can't say with all assurance, Brother Rodney, if I died right now and go to be with Jesus, then dear friend, I want you to slip your hand up right now. I want to pray with you and for you. Ask us if you'd help me. Raise your hand up high. I want to pray with you and for you. Quickly. Raise up high. Right now. Obey the Holy Ghost. Thank you in the balcony. God bless you. Anybody else? Thank you down here on the main floor. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you right at the back. God bless you. Quickly, raise your hand. Let me see it. Yes, I've seen your hand. Anybody else? Slip up your hand right now. He's calling you right at the back there. God bless you. Anyone else? Quickly. He calls you now. Quickly, slip your hand up now. He's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. Quickly. Anyone else? Don't delay. Don't put it off till tomorrow. Thank you. God bless you. What you heard here tonight was the sound of heaven. What you heard here tonight was the sound of heaven. Slip up your hand. Say, pray for me. I need Jesus. I need to be born again. Thank you. Anybody else? Don't put it off till tomorrow. Thank you. God's calling you now. Today is the day of salvation. Don't harden your heart. If you hear His voice, thank you. God bless you. Anybody else? While heads are bowed and eyes are closed, you might be here today and you're a believer. You gave your life to Jesus. But you have grown cold. You know that you're not in the place you should be with God. You just know it. You say, Brother Rodney, I'm just not in the place. I know. Even tonight, as I sensed the Spirit of God, I felt the Holy Spirit dealing with me. The things in my life that has to change. I've got to let go. I must come back. I've got to come into that place of my first love. I've got to come into that place that I once had, that fervency I had with God. If that's you, dear friend, right now, and you want to rededicate, recommit your life, what a better time to do it than right now. Slip your hand up quickly, right now, all over the building. Thank you. Hands are going up everywhere. Quickly, put your hand up now. Don't delay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Right now. Right now. Right now. Slip your hand up high. So I'll rededicate my life to Jesus tonight afresh. As God was calling these people to the ministry and God was calling these people that are in the ministry to a deeper realm. There's people in the balcony. Thank you. On the main floor. God's calling you to come back. Thank you. Anybody else? Quickly. Right now. Right now. All right. While heads are bowed and eyes are closed, one last invitation. If you've come here tonight and you say, Brother Rodney, I'm not sure on my salvation. I love God. I go to church every week. I try to serve Him as much as I can, but the devil's always lying to me. He tells me, you're not saved. You're not born again. And tonight, I just want to make sure once and for all, Jesus is my Lord and Savior. If that's you right now, right where you are, quickly slip your hand up now and say, pray for me. Thank you. Quickly, right now, slip it up high. Anybody else? Thank you back there. Thank you back there. Thank you over here. God bless you. Thank you over there. Thank you over there. God bless you. I want everyone to look at me now, please, if you would. Everyone. In this section over here, going right to the back, if you didn't raise your hand on those three invitations, you either want to be saved, come back to God, or make sure you did not raise your hand, but you want to be included in the prayer. I'm going to pray for those three invitations, either to be saved, come back to God, or make sure. I want you to slip your hand up now and say, include me, quickly. Anybody else? Don't delay. He's waiting for you right now. Slip your hand up. Anybody else? Right now, in this section over here, going all the way up into the balcony, if you didn't raise your hand on those three invitations, but you want to be included in the prayer, I'm going to pray for those three invitations, either to be saved, come back to God, or make sure, put your hand up now, in Jesus' name, quickly, thank you. Anybody else? Ushers, help me, the lights are shining in my eyes. In the balcony, quickly, slip your hand up now. Anybody else? Right now, He's calling you. In this middle section here, if you didn't raise your hand on those three invitations, but you want to be included in the prayer, I'm going to pray for those three invitations, either to be saved, come back to God, or make sure. Just slip your hand up right now and say, include me. Quickly. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Right at the back. Thank you. God bless you. I see your hands. Anybody else? All right, in this session, going all the way up into the balcony, if you didn't raise your hand on those three invitations, but you want to be included in the prayer, I'm going to pray for those three invitations, either to be saved, come back to God, and make sure. Put your hand up now. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else? Quickly. Quickly. Do it now. All right. Then in this section over here, if you didn't raise your hand on those three invitations, but you want to be included in the prayer, I'm going to pray for those three invitations. I want you to quickly slip your hand up right now and say, include me. Right now. All right. I want everyone that raised your hand on those invitations to stand all over the building. Stand. 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 Everyone that raised your hand, stand. Stand. Stand up right now. Stand up right now. Stand up right now. I want you to come. 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 Come on down. Come on down. Come on down now. Come on down now. Come on down now. Come on down now.
Oh, how he loves you and me.
Come on down now. Tonight is your night. Watch here. Watch here. Right here, put them right here. Put them right here. Come here. Right over here. Right over here. Right over here. Come. These others you know you should be down here. Get out of your seat and get down here now. Come. 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 He's calling you now. He's calling you now. And me. Oh, how he loves you and me.
Oh, how he loves you and me.
He gave his life.
He gave his life.
What more could he give? Oh, how he loves you.
Oh, how he loves you. Oh, how he loves me. Oh, how he loves you and me.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, if you had asked me before the service, what is happening tonight? I would have said, I don't know. Some brother's going to play a fiddle. And the New Life Choir are going to sing. That's all I knew. But you know, when God wants to do something, he can do it. We just got to yield to him. And I am well aware of this, that we could have got 10 different ministers up here tonight and they would have flowed a different way with the Holy Ghost and yielded the Holy Ghost a different way. And that's fine. You know, some people want to have a service where they yield to the Holy Spirit and nobody's in charge. Anything without a head is a monster. Anything with two heads is a freak. Somebody must catch the wave of God. Somebody must be an interpreter. Somebody must say, okay, this is what God's doing. And I believe God will do that if you yield to him. If you learn the way of the Holy Ghost. If you learn the ways of the Spirit of God. If you learn to yield to the Holy Ghost. If you learn the way of the anointing. Now, there's still one other thing I must do after this. And if people are gone, I can't help it. I'm just going to obey the Holy Ghost. I can't help it if they had to leave. Well, Brother Rodney, you called for that and we had to leave. Well, it's not my fault. I was here. But before we do that, I want to pray with you. I want you to look at me. Every one of you right now, God loves you. Every one of you. Standing here today, three groups of people. Those that have never been born again. Secondly, those that have come to recommit your life. And thirdly, those that have come to make sure. I want you to know tonight you're going to leave this place changed by the power of God. If you mean business with God, God means business with you. Won't you just close your eyes right now and raise your right hand to heaven? That's where your help comes from. And pray this prayer right now. Say, Father, I come to you in the precious name of your Son, Jesus. Lord, you said in your word, if I confess with my mouth, Jesus Christ of Nazareth is my Lord and my Savior, and I believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead, I will be saved. So, Father, right now, I confess Jesus Christ of Nazareth is my Lord and my Savior. Come into my heart right now. Take out the stony heart. Put in a heart of flesh. Wash me. Cleanse me. Change me. Fill me. Use me. Let me never be the same again. Thank you for dying for me on the cross. Thank you for shedding your blood for me. Thank you that on the third day you rose for me. And thank you that you're coming back again for me. In Jesus' name.